Senators Lovely, Tar, McGee, cover our general footprint. Glad you're representatives. Carousel, the main driver we want to get here in this forum here is that there's not enough housing to cover the income spectrum that we need. You've heard about it today at length. You can submit some written testimony, so I'll skip some of this stuff here. But the housing developers essentially are not going to get close to being able to generate 17,000 units a year if we don't do something about policy. We're not going to get there. Nobody's going to get there. We're going to talk about it for years, and we're still not going to get there. With this in mind, I'd like to speak in favor of House Bill 1111, touching on three elements of the bill. First one is the zoning issue. The current zoning system that we have is designed to exclude, and it is effective in that effort. Not long ago, we used to exclude or segregate people by income and or race. Various elements and tools like redlining, roads, bridges, and other public infrastructure. These tools became publicly unacceptable, so we've shifted now to others. And currently, zoning and limited public infrastructure, sometimes which is intentional, serve these same functions, isolating and excluding portions of the population. The result is that many communities wield their zoning laws with the intent to support only single-family housing on large lots, blocking only family housing, especially housing that may accommodate children. I spend a lot of hours with planning boards, zoning boards, any kind of board that has any authority over housing where I'm working, and I would be embarrassed to repeat what a lot of people say about human children and their efforts to discourage family housing. Most land in the state, large majority, over 3/4, cannot be used for multi-family housing, and many communities have not built anything with a single-family house in a long time. The result is predictable. We get what we build. Communities with resources use vast amounts of land cobbled together into 2-acre lots to house very few people, effectively keeping out certain groups of other people. Communities without resources are then in the opposite situation with much higher ratio of multifamily housing. This self-imposed zoning then results in fewer multifamily units being created while at the same time raising the land costs in these affluent communities, which exacerbates the economic segregation. In the face of our 17,000 unit per year need, these practices can't be continued. As Mass Housing Partnership has noted, the local zoning challenge is the primary cause of our housing predicament. Thankfully, since this is self-imposed, we have the power to change it, and we should, and this bill will allow that. Two items quickly, because I'm already out of time here. Small-scale development, we think it's great. I thought we should do that. Especially in our communities, we can do places under 20 units or less. There is a lot of local fallow CPA money in the community that I work in. We have this major need for housing. They're controlling the money. They can't get it, largely because they can't build something that they need to scale. You give me a 20-unit or less platform, I will crank out some units on the North Shore and get that money unlocked. Lastly, 40S. We love 40S. We think it's a great idea, especially with 40R. Two issues we'd like to raise. One is, if they do decouple 40S and 40R, if they expand 40R beyond, I'm sorry, 40S beyond 40R, to please carry the 40S affordability requirements wherever 40S goes. And a big one for us is that 40S is a big tool to deal with the pressure against school children. One of the major challenges against using it, and Carmen and I have discussed a lot lately, is the municipalities are worried about the consistency of 40S over time. And even if we could give them a small window, local municipal officials who otherwise would be supportive, they just need a little bit of political cover. They feel very anxious about saying, before this thing even gets built, we could lose 40S, and then they'll get cooked politically. So that was close to under 4 minutes, but probably. Thank you.
Any questions for the panel?